expanded standard deduction. So the reality of it is simplification has nothing to do with the number of brackets you have. It has everything to do with how many times you have to itemize, or can you have a simpler path to doing your taxes that will cost you less money and less time in taxes.
Okay, when the president kissed that postcard, is he going to be happy with this? Are we ever going to see that very simple postcard come to fruition for tax reform?
Well, the fact of the matter is that you can use the postcard, probably more likely an app on your phone to do your taxes. Once you know which bracket you're in, the simplification through through the elimination of itemization is a very powerful tool for simplification.
Mnuchin promised we would see tax reform by Christmas. As you stand here right now, we are awaiting Kevin Brady on the House side to make some comments. That's actually been gummed up, Senator, and we are waiting to hear how that comes about. But you saw a pretty significant drop in the markets today on fears that it's so complicated that side is not going to get it done. Can you say that the Senate is ready to say, let's get this done so we can give in on this promise here?
Absolutely. Here's the truth. On Monday, we'll start the process of marking it up in committee. Mm-hmm. And before we're done with the week, we will have an affirmative vote to move tax reform to the full floor. Once it gets on the floor, before middle of December, this will be a foregone conclusion. We'll be able to go through conference committee. And if there are any differences between the House and the Senate, we'll have those solved before Christmas.
Well, I know the Senate's Merry job Christmas. Is not to prop up the stock market, but you'd be happy to note at the moment that while the Dow had been down earlier by 253 points, we've come back pretty dramatically. We are now down 118 points, but now 115. So we're really starting to try and fight back. But I have to ask you, sir, what about carried interest? As we're getting the details of the Senate plan, I don't see that loophole, some call it welfare for the rich, even mentioned in the Senate plan. Can you clarify?
Certainly. I think the easiest way to clarify it is that the process of going through the Finance Committee will take every other deduction that people are concerned about, likely to include carried interest, and we'll have a robust conversation about how to treat that, whether we treat it as ordinary income or not. There's certainly going to be...
What do you think? Should this be treated as ordinary income? Because right now, there are some billionaires, and we've been putting up the billboard of these guys. Some of them are in... Most of them are in private equity. And they're the ones who are paying a 20% tax bracket rate, while almost all of our viewers... And we do have a lot of CEOs and wealthy people, but CEOs sure. have to pay a regular rate. But these guys do not. They're at 20%. What do you personally think? Where would you stand on that?
It's pretty simple. We want earned income to be taxed as earned income, and we want profit to be taxed at the lower rate. But what we're going to do through the next few weeks is examine that process to make sure that we capture all earned income that should be taxed at the ordinary rate.
Okay, because they're saying, well, I hold on to my business for this long, the Leon Blacks, the Stephen Schwartzmans. Listen, our slogan, sir, is the power to prosper. We have no problem saying capitalism lives here at Fox Business. However, if you're going to hurt middle class and take away a deduction there, shouldn't the pain be distributed amongst all of us?
Absolutely. Anyone who looks at our tax reform package and does not see how unique and specific we are making sure that the distribution table impacts folks who have versus those who do not have. It will be very clear to see that in our distribution tables.
I don't envy you guys because you've got lobbyists slithering under the conference room doors constantly. And I get it. It's hard, but you really don't want to do anything that hurts the middle class without doing something that will make it fairer. I know you hear me, Senator. Thank you so much.
Listen, I think you're right. That's what our goal has been, to make sure that tax reform benefits all taxpayers, and we've skewed it towards the middle class without any question.
Good to see you, Senator. Thank you so much. Tim Scott.